Hi student, welcome back. And today we are going to continue our lesson about the factors that are affecting the rate of reaction. Okay, so of course, there are temperature, pressure, concentration, catalyst, pressure, and size. So basically, we can see some relationship, correct or not? If temperature increase, reaction increase, correct or not? Hot means faster lah. You cook something, you put more fire, then faster reaction, you cook also faster. You put catalyst, increase reaction. Catalyst like our saliva, biological catalyst. Chemical catalyst like nickel or what? That one we'll go to it lah. Catalyst something like to make the reaction faster, like saliva, for example. Concentration, more concentration means faster. Like I already mentioned, if you put more acid, that is stronger acid, the reaction is faster. Pressure, same like you, if you use pressure cooker, pressure what, maybe your cooking is faster also, so it's faster. Size, if you use a small size, it's easier to cook rather than big size, right? Like, how do you say, you know, chop, you cook, right? If you don't want to chop, you cook, then sometimes you cut the chicken. Why inside red color one? Haven't cooked. Okay, so yes, the smaller the size, the reaction will also increase. Okay, now I need to prove you. The people ask you to show me. Okay, let's do the experiment of temperature and rate of reaction. We want to do that if the hypothesis, if the temperature increase, the rate of reaction increase. So what I want to do is I want to use the temperature and sodium thiosulfate solution mark an X. So they want to do this experiment. To make it fast, I will just say that they will do this experiment with the same amount of reactant and liquid but different temperature, correct or not? Because the constant variable is the size, the volume, and the concentration. And the thing that they want to change is the temperature. Okay, how does this experiment happen? I will show you YouTube lah. If you see YouTube, you will understand more. Just press this experiment and you search on YouTube. Basically, in this experiment, they will put sulfuric acid and sodium thiosulfate, and it will become white color. Maybe you color can become slowly, it will become white color. If you increase the temperature, it will become white color faster. The water will become like a milk. And now we know that it will become white color, we want to change the temperature. So basically, you can see that here, even you don't do the experiment, here we'll say that temperature in 35 and 50. So basically, we know, roughly we know that 50 seconds is faster. This one will be slow. Time taken where X is no longer. So faster, maybe I will put here. Roughly, I guess. Just put here 10 seconds, for example. 10 seconds, 15 seconds, 20, and 25. Roughly, I guess. Correct or not? Because the hotter the object, the faster the reaction. 1 over time, so just use my calculator, 1 divided by 10, I get 1 over 10, which is actually, change it to decimal point, 0.1, 1 divided by 15, 0.06, 21, you can see here, 1 divided by the time, 1 divided by 20, you get 0.05. 1 divided by 25, you get 0.04. So we can see that the time graph, it will become like, here will be fast, will be bigger number than the rest, correct or not? This is 0.04, it's a smaller number. Why they want to do this? Basically, they want to sketch the graph in terms of They want to do the graph lah, so that the graph will be like, let me think, the as the hot it will increase, correct lah. So the graph will be like that lah. So this one I will write the time. Sorry, the manipulator will be the temperature. So the graph is like this. So this is the temperature, and this will be the time. 1/time. So that as the temperature increase, this one also increase. Correct or not? Then it will become like a graph that is easier. Why you want to divide? So that you can draw a graph. Because if you don't want to divide, let's assume this is the temperature. Temperature. And this one will be, the graph will be like 25, 20, it will be like this. So actually can, this is science, both graph also can, it shows something. But this one is better because it can show the understanding. Because you say that the increased temperature, the rate of reaction is faster. This one also can, but it is more difficult to see because the increase of temperature, the time taken is lesser. So both of this is correct, but this will be better. Easy to see ma. You want easy to see or you don't want easy to see? Easy to see, right? So you just use 1 divided by the time. So from this graph, I show to you, this is science, I prove to you by evidence and observation that the hypothesis is accepted. As the temperature increase, the rate of reaction increase. You don't believe me? Now you can look at my graph. I show you my graph. This one, the experiment, this is how I do my experiment, Of course, no experiment is perfect. There will just, there's some weaknesses in the experiment, but you won't do this now. You will learn this in your university or college because you need to present your experiment when you go to university. Then people will say, why like that? You say CX, but actually X by your IC are not accurate, you know, because it's your eye, you know. You cannot use eye to see. You need to use computer laser pointing, something like that lah, when you go to university. But as for now, this is the basic understanding of science. So the conclusion is, the higher the temperature, the faster the rate of reaction. Question. State the factor that affect the rate of reaction in the experiment. So what is the answer? So the answer will be time, obviously, because this experiment is already talked about time, right? It's not about, remember there are 5 factors. When you talk about the factor that affect the reaction, we are talking about temperature, catalyst, the physical side of the reaction, concentration, so forgot already. Pressure, okay? Pressure. So obviously this one we are talking about temperature, right? You get what I mean or not? We are talking about temperature. Okay, temperature. Just put down the answer, temperature. This is not testing about concentration, right? This is not testing about size. Because I already showed you, right? You see here or not? This, I changed the temperature. That is why I'm testing the temperature. I hope you understand. But sometimes don't understand how to say this. It's temperature, okay? It's in the notes. I just copy what is from the notes, okay? The notes say temperature, you see? Temperature. Yeah. Okay, here and you see the hypothesis, you see? Temperature. I don't go to that. Everywhere is temperature. You see my graph also temperature. How does the factor concern affect the rate of reaction? I will just copy back the hypothesis. The hypothesis is, I don't want to write down, I just read the hypothesis. It's the same. That I already show you, the higher the temperature of reactant, the higher the rate of reaction. How you know? I already show you the experiment, you understand or not? This experiment, I show you the data, I show you the graph, I show you everything already. You don't say I say wrong. You can say I say wrong, but you need to say like in the science, like scientists, okay, your eye wrong, your experiment you put wrong, the volume you put wrong. It must be like a valid science like professor like that lah, huh? So how does it, the factor of the concern, the increase the temperature, the increase the rate of reaction. State the operation definition of the rate of reaction based on this experiment. So operand definition for rate of reaction. What's the definition of rate of reaction? So this one, when we are talking about the rate of reaction, operation definition is actually the definition, but it's more specific to this experiment. So actually operation definition is the definition, but it's more specific. So I would say probably, the rate of reaction will increase with the rate of reaction increase linearly. The rate of reaction increase linearly with temperature. It's still the same thing lah. This one I'm not sure, but it's the definition of rate of reaction lah, or the changes of reactant over per unit of time. That is also the definition of rate of reaction. This one I'm not sure. Yeah, let me think for a while. Operation definition of rate of reaction. Yeah, I think I changed my answer. I think I write this better. The change of mass in reactant, not reactor. Reactant. Affected by temperature per unit of time. So I just copy back the definition, I add in temperature, because operation definition is more specific. So I want to bring in the concept of temperature. This one I'm not sure, but I think this is the answer that I will give. But to be honest, I'm not sure about this answer. Okay, now already talk about temperature, let's talk about the concentration. Okay, now you say concentration, more strong acid means faster. How? Okay, I this is how I do. I take 0.1, 0.1, say 0.12, 0.11, 0.1 more. Of course, 0.2 is the strongest more, means stronger acid. 0.04 is the lesser not concentrated. So this one is more concentrated. 比较kit啦, more concentrated. And this is less. What I need to do is, before you no need to read everything, you need to, in your mind, you imagine. I need to put the same experiment, concentrated, it will be faster, so I cannot see the X. Slower one, it will be slower, so I can see the X in the longer one. Though I haven't do the experiment, roughly, I will guess that this one will be faster to unable see the X. So this one, I will probably say anything lah, huh? Maybe this one 10 seconds. This one is faster. This one is slower. So I'll put here 15, 20, 25. 30 example lah. Of course, you cannot do like that. You need to do experiment, but it will be increasing in order because the water will become white color. More concentrated, the water become X white color faster, and when it become X, your eye cannot see. So I cannot see X in 10 seconds. I cannot see X in 15 seconds. I cannot see X in 20 seconds. I cannot see X in 25 seconds. I cannot see X in 30 seconds. Divided it. Let me press calculator and divide. Okay, so roughly I already do 0.01, 0.06, 0.05, 0.04. So if I want to draw the graph, obviously they ask you to do the graph. Let's say the question asks you to draw a graph. Why Bangkok? Sorry. Okay, let's do the graph. Make it straight a bit. Usually at the x-axis is the manipulated variable, which is, I would say here is the concentration. Concentration with the unit of mole dm negative 3, the unit lah. You need to write the unit. Let's say the question asks you to draw the unit. Mole dm negative 3, and this one will be the second s negative 1. It depends on how you want to do it, or you want to put s. So the concentration is 0.2, 0.16, and so on. 0.2, of course it's not nice lah, but in this, you use your ruler to do nicely. 0.12, 0.08. For this one, it will be 0.1. Why they want to do like this? Yeah, it's too violent. Concentration, this is higher, right? So this one will be 10 seconds. To be no longer invisible, it's 10 seconds. So the graph will be something like, wait, 0.1, 0.06, and so on. So the graph is something like this. If you want to draw like this, lah, I prefer to draw go up, but you say graph against time. Oh, so you got two graph. Graph conjugate again, time, graph again. So you got two graph. One graph is go up. One graph is go down. Go up one is against time. Go down because it's over per time. You get what I mean or not? I hope you... It's quite complicated. Actually, I got no place to do that, and I'm not teaching mathematics. I don't want to go too deep into this, but the graph is one go up, one go down because they ask you to draw the two graphs. I just follow the data. Okay, the data given in the question. Conclusion of experiment, as I mentioned, from form 1 until form 5, I stopped already. I don't know where I'm talking about. It's not like I'm old, but when you stop, you just don't know where you are talking about. Where was I? Oh my god, I cannot. No way was I stopped. Okay, the hypothesis. As I mentioned, now I remember back. Oh my god. From form 1 until form 5, your hypothesis is always the same. Hypothesis accepted. Just copy back. The conclusion is hypothesis accepted. Copy from the hypothesis, hypothesis accepted. Until when you go to university, then it can be wrong. This is the downside of Malaysian education, I say. Because in Malaysia, the experiment is always successful. You do in your question, it's always correct. But in IGCSE, in the UK syllabus, sometimes they say no due to sometimes human error. Because you put wrong thing, man. They will give you a story. Then they will ask you, okay, why this guy do wrong? Maybe he put wrong thing. Maybe he see wrongly or his calculation. Wrongly. So the hypothesis is no. But for SPM, it is always yes. So... I think they should put the no, like not what to study. Now I tell you, you just copy, right? Just put yes, just put yes, just put yes. Everything just put as you just to get correct. So yeah, it's a difference between the Malaysian education system and other country. Accepted, what's the conclusion? Copy back this one, the hypothesis, which is hypothesis accepted, the higher the concentration of the reactant, the higher the rate of reaction. This one you write down, you will get 1 mark. This is the conclusion. Lastly, let's look at the how does the factor affected the rate of how does the factor affected the rate of reaction? Where was I? This one. Accepted. Okay, sorry. Question number 1. State the factor that affected. What is the factor? Very easy. It's the concentration, right? Don't say you don't know. Because this whole experiment, we are talking about concentration. If you say you don't know what I'm talking about, it's like, I don't know, it's like, sometimes I feel weird. Is there the whole thing, the whole time we are talking about the concentration? Don't say you don't know. We are not talking about temperature. We are not talking about size. We are not talking about catalyst. We are talking about concentration. How you know? Because the whole experiment is talking about concentration. So the answer is concentration. I need to repeat many times because I just get some students don't understand what I'm talking about. How does the factor increase the rate of reaction? Of course, the more concentrated then the faster the rate of reaction. I think it will be the same like the hypothesis. Okay, the faster, the more concentrated the reactant, the faster the rate of reaction. Okay. Okay, so thank you very much. I hope that you understand. We have a few more experiments to go. Actually, it's the same thing. This chapter is so long, but it's talking the same thing only. Another three experiments to go. Because three factors we haven't learned yet. I hope that you enjoy this video and see you next time. Bye-bye.